What's up, you guys? It's Chicago's own Tink, and right now we rocking with lifestylehustle.com, and I'm here with DJ Poizon. Turn up, y'all.
A wise man told me the first step towards change is awareness. The second step is acceptance. Are you aware of the changes that are happening around you? Are you willing to accept the change that is...
What's up, everybody? It's your girl, DJ Poizon Ivy, checking in today. I got my girl... If you do not know about this chick, you are sleeping somewhere under a rock. She is about to take over. What's up, Tink?
What's going on?
How are you?
I'm good. I'm very good.
Good. So, yeah. Good, good. Now, this is crazy. I'm going to throw it back a little bit. I remember running into you about, I want to say, a year and a half ago at DTLR. And Mike Streets was like, hey, this is Tink. She's dope. You should meet her. And, you know, we linked up. And it's so incredible to see all your success thus far. Congratulations. How does it feel?
Thank you. It feels great, actually. Like, just everything that happened, that can happen in a year.
Uh-huh.
It's amazing.
Man,
I feel good about it.
That's great. That's great. So you are a signee to Mosley Music Group / Epic Records.
Yeah.
So how have things changed? I mean, you know, we know a lot has changed, but what's the biggest change from being an independent artist to signing to a label and having a great mentor and of course Timbaland? So how has that been for you?
Things have changed, you know what I mean, but you know, everything is still grounded and true. Like Timbaland, when he came in and helped me with my project, like we didn't change much about Tink, you know.
Oh,
what I'm saying,
yes,
like
ma'am.
He's all about me staying true to me, which is great. But yeah, things have just picked up, you know what I'm saying. Like definitely a bigger level of respect having Tim on my shoulder. Yeah, like
that's gotta be.
Yeah,
good.
So it's a good feeling. You just don't know. People have they coming around.
They do. And speaking to Timbaland, staying true to who you are, discovered or heard your record when he heard the record from the interns, right?
Yeah, don't tell nobody. He was in LA at the studio when they played my record and it just caught his ear, you know, when he heard it. He wanted to know, you know, who I was, and he flew me out like the next day, and I met him. It was just real, you know, real epic the way it happened.
That's what's up. Shout out to the interns, shout out to the homies coasting too, you know. Guys,
yeah,
Chicago
too.
Yeah, for sure. So let's talk a little bit about social media, because I know Tink Squad is really heavy and it ride for your girl, right?
Yeah.
And so I know you spend a lot of time on Twitter, but you know, in the news recently, Twitter's been spot where everybody's jumping off and clapping back and whatnot. So now that things, you know, are going up for you, how is that changing your view on social media?
You know what, my thing about social media is that, like, you can't overdo it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I like to keep that element of mystique.
Right.
You know, like, I show people what I want them to see, but you know, when they know too much, they think they know you like that, or you know, they can get bored because you know you're too accessible. I like
exactly.
to keep it low key. It helps me in my personal life too. You know?
Exactly. But as an artist still, I know you interact with your fans a lot too. So
of course, of
like
course.
To you,
yeah,
know?
That's the good part about social media, the best part.
Right. That's what's up. Okay, so now let's talk about the music. I'm so excited. Can you tell us what is in the future? Can we expect any mixtapes, EPs, albums? What's the new thing that's about to drop?
You can expect my first single produced by Timbaland.
Yes.
It's called Ratchet Commandments, and this is just, it's bigger than just a song. It's like a movement. It's like the next level of hip-hop, you know what I mean? And it's like Timbaland is, you know, he's like rejuvenated almost.
Timbaland is Tim is back.
Yeah, that's exactly how I want to put it. So the single Ratchet Commandments, the video, the visual, like I'm really trying to take it to the next level. You know, back when Tim was around, you know, videos were important. And you know, it's different now. Like people kind of just, they can just slap anything together and call it a video, but we taking time out to really push it together. So
what's up? Now, do you feel, I mean, of course we all know the history of Timbaland. Do you feel any pressure at all given the fact that he had worked with, you know, some of the most legendary female artists of our time, and Aaliyah, Missy Elliott? Does that put pressure on you, or does it put pressure in a good way, you know? Or
exactly. I was going to say, like, never a bad pressure. I think that's what motivates me the most, because sometimes, you know, it just gives me that motivation. Like, you know, I'm working with one of the best. You know what I'm saying? It's almost like a confirmation that I got it, you know? So it's never a bad thing. Yeah, I think it helps me in the studio.
That means I'm made under pressure, girl, for sure. So
yeah, that's true too.
Right. And so I just actually, you know, got done reading the Fader interview that just came out. Congratulations on that.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
They got you and Chance and the Social Experiment covering the Spring Style issue. How does it feel to get into these bigger publications and, you know, having them really want to get to know you and know the real story?
Man, it's different. You know, the thing about me, like, I'm not the type to sugarcoat anything, and I think that's the best part about, like, those big interviews and cover stories. It's like, you know, it's finally an artist that's not fabricating shit, or, you know, she doesn't, her mindset isn't like so-and-so, and, you know, she's being herself. So it helps a lot just to put it on a higher pedestal. It's like everything.
That's what's up. So now, okay, so, you know, the All-Star game just pass and whatnot. So we're gonna put together Tink's All-Star squad, right?
Okay.
So give me your top five artists of all time. You got five, right? We can do a plus one for the sixth man. So what does that look like?
Five artists of all time.
Uh-huh.
Biggie Smalls.
I know that's a tough one, man.
Yeah, it really is, because there's so many great artists in different genres.
Right.
Okay, we got Biggie Smalls. Who else can I say?
Any vocalists in particular? Or?
Of course, Lauren.
Of course.
You know, she's an inspiration. Okay, that's two. Drake.
Okay.
Yeah, the new school Drake.
We can do somebody on the come up, too.
Tupac. You can't have, you know what I'm saying. I would never.
We can't.
Yeah. And then, oh, wow, that's so hard. What am I at, four?
You're at four. I'm going to put you on the spot. We got to see. Okay, so how about somebody from the city, somebody from Chicago, somebody, you know, that you, is there anybody?
Yeah, Big Brother, Chance the Rapper.
Okay.
Big Brother.
Sure, yeah. Chance is dope. That's what's up. Okay, so now we going to, you know, we have the Think Tink hashtag popping off. So I want to start something new. We're going to call it a Tink Turn Up.
Okay,
so
I like that.
What are your, like, three turn up songs right now? What is Tink jamming to?
Man, you'd be so surprised. Like,
that's why I ask. Cause I think sometimes, you know, we think that we listen to everything on the radio. But what's the thing?
Yeah,
you know?
A turn up song for me. What's the joint by Disclosure? Latch.
Yes.
Latch. How you know? I didn't even say the title. You latch. Latch.
Girl, cause we here.
Latch. Drake. Energy. Uh-huh. Off his new album. And then my third turn up song. That's so hard, you know, because I listen to everything. You'd be so surprised.
Right.
The third turn up song would probably be
that somebody think.
You know what? It's actually Trap Queen.
Fetty Wap.
Yeah, I like that joint.
That's man. That's what's up.
Yeah.
Maybe you can hop on a little remix or something, you know?
Yeah, his voice is cool.
That's what's up. Now, I know one thing that I really like about you is that, you know, you rap and you sing. Do you feel like you at some point have to define your style? Because I feel like that's your style, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, honestly, though, I think the way the music is moving, it's almost like accepted. Because you think about it, like, a lot of male rappers are singing within their raps, and, you know, like, with the auto tune and, you know, just the melodies, it's almost like people are singing now and using it as rap. So I don't think I have to, you know, like, expand or try to define it. It's music, you know. I'm an artist, so you get what you get, you like what you hear.
That's what's up. And so who do you feel like, is there a specific audience that your music is specifically targeted to? Because I know as a girl, I listen to your records and I get all in my feelings. And, you know, I wish you were out when I was like 17, because I write in my diary and listen to your music.
And that's the thing, like, you know, Think Tink is like it's the voice of my generation.
Right.
And I really do rap for the girls, for the young girls. You know what I mean? Like, I'm the artist that, you know, you probably can play my shit around your parents, because it's just the truth and
it's real life.
It's honest. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not just talking about anything no more. Like, that's the big difference. Think Tink.
Exactly. That's what's up. Now, I don't know, you write a lot of, you know, also all your music and whatnot. So have you ever considered possibly writing for somebody else, or do you think that it'll be different because you draw so much from your experiences?
Yeah, I always think about writing. You know, I think about that when I'm talking to publishers and whatnot, but you'd be surprised. I've been writing since I was 12, and when I was a kid, I was writing anything. So, you know, like, country and pop. Right. Like, I really get into every genre I could touch. So, of course, I love writing. It's a hobby.
That's dope. And so you back in Chicago. You have the show tomorrow, Reggie?
Yeah, I'll be at Metro, not Reggie.
Metro, I'm sorry.
Metro.
Okay, got
yeah.
you.
Metro, tomorrow night, it's going to be live, you know.
So now you home. You bringing out any special guests? Because you at the house, you got to pull out some tricks. Or
of course.
Is there anything you planning some special surprises?
Of course. There's always a surprise with me.
Okay.
You get a different experience every show.
Every single show. That's what's up. Whatever you heard of, y'all make sure you check her out tomorrow night at yep. Metro. Make sure you support this superstar in the making.
Thank
I am
you.
So excited for you and for your movement.
Appreciate
and
it.
And make sure you let the people know how they can reach you.
Yeah, you can follow me on Twitter at @official_tink. And my Instagram is official_tink.
That's what's yeah. up. Tink, it's your girl.
Tink is the movement.
Poizon Ivy signing off, man. Until next time. About that life, you can roll with me, no.